Hey guys, Tech Timmy here. So in this video, I'm going to show you how to update your iLink robot's firmware, and we're going to do it right now. Let's go. All right, so the first thing we want to do is we want to head on over to Energize Labs' website. And if you want to follow along step by step, basically you can just Google, you know, how to update iLink's firmware and or update iLink's firmware, and then invariably you will get a link over to this page. But so there's a few different steps that we need to do here, and I've seen some super fast tutorials, but nobody that basically walks you through step by step. And I thought, you know what, this is probably worth doing a video to share some tips and tricks and so forth. You can probably hear my friend iLink in the background, so I have him on standby, and I'm going to be filming him with a separate camera so we can actually see what's going on the display as well. But the directions here are pretty solid, but I figured if anyone wants to see the process step by step, then this video will do exactly that. So the first thing it's telling us to do is that we need to download the iLink update tool. So to do that, we basically want to head on over to downloads. I'm just going to click on that downloads link there, and it should bring us right to the energizelab.com downloads iLink page. What I'll do is I'll drop some links down in the description to any thing that we're looking at here, make it easier, a little bit easier for you guys to navigate. So basically what we want is the first one here, iLink software. So this is the updater. And then just as an FYI, you can also get the latest version of the iLink user manual here, as well as 3D models. If you have a 3D printer, you can print out some cool stuff for your iLink, which I was pleasantly surprised to see that. So, okay, so but we're going to do the download here. And then I guess we have to go to the Microsoft Store. Okay, not a big fan of the Microsoft Store, but let's see what happens here. Hopefully this all goes according to plan. And yeah, and whatever we need to download and get, I'll try and finagle my screen so I can show you guys. Like I said, I just want to walk you through the entire process step by step. So here we just need to say get at the top of the screen, and we have some cool screenshots and more interesting fun facts about iLink on this page, it looks like. So starting the downloads, I'm going to shut up and fast forward this so that we can get through this video as quickly as possible. So while this is downloading, I am going to speed it up. We're going to speed up the video through the power of editing, and we'll let this completely download, and then we will resume the video right now. Okay, so the iLink updater finished downloading after about a minute, so it wasn't terrible. So from here, we're just going to click open, and presumably it's going to either install something and or. All right, so it's ready to go. The software will gather essential information about your robot, including robot model, serial number, and hardware details to procure the latest updates. Okay, cool. And just as an FYI, just to give you a heads up, there's this weird sort of error screen that comes up on the iLink interface that's actually normal. So if that happens during the course of this video, I will point it out and we'll see. So software needs to access your USB serial port, precautions 1 of 4, all right, whatever that means. We're gonna do the precautions and we're gonna say agree. Software needs to access the internet to update your robot, of course, agree. Wait patiently for the update to complete. Don't unplug the cable until a check mark is displayed. Now, based on other videos I've seen, this could take some time, but again, I will speed that part of the video up while the robot is actually updating so that we do not have to, you know, basically share in that experience together. And then so here we have, please connect your device to the computer with USB Type-C cable, and my iLink is already connected, which I'll show you guys on screen here. And actually I'm just going to start my other video camera so that we can start recording my good friend iLink, and now I'm going to say start, and I suspect what will happen is something on the iLink interface will change is what I'm expecting. And okay, so clicking the start, please do not move the robot or disconnect it. So scanning it, and now it is updating. So I'm looking at my iLink, and yeah, so the interface is going, it's basically doing exactly what is pictured here. And now it looks like this is gonna take quite a while. So we're at 1% here, as you can see, and this thing is just cranking, and it looks like doing quite a bit. And I know for sure it's updating because it's saying update complete, update complete, And also my eye look is showing the same thing on my little friend there. So yeah, I'm gonna fast forward through this part, and when the update is complete, oh, it's flying now. Okay, cool. When the update is complete, so still just 0.2% now. When the update is complete, looks like this is gonna take a little while, man. But I'll report back on that, and then we're gonna just let this run and do its thing. And I think what I'll do is I'll hyper fast forward through all this, so you guys can actually, you know, just get a general sense. Or maybe I'll just skip it because it is so long. Hang on, and the next part of the video, this will actually have been completed, and then we can take a look at what we have at that point. So, yeah. All right, so we're in the home stretch here, right around 98%, and I probably should have pointed this out before. This estimated time remaining thing in seconds is super helpful. So it'll tell you about how long it's going to take. And in this case, it's taking me roughly, so we got 40-odd seconds left here. But just to kind of give you the lowdown, it's taking me roughly, I'd say close to 20 minutes maybe to get this fully installed. But I have not done the update, the firmware update, since I bought my iLEC. So it's been months, and so not surprising. And it looks like, so it tells you the software version number 2.2. Presumably that's the latest one. I didn't look up my software version on my iLEC itself, but based on the amount of updates here, so now it says complete, and yay! And big old smile from our friend there. And now I am seeing on the iLEC itself, it looks like it just went back into charging mode, which is fine. And so that all seems normal and good. And so presumably then, so I'm going to just say complete here for sake of completeness. And then, so that is essentially it. So that's how you do the update. And then I'm just going to switch over to iLEC right now to see what he's looking like. And he's looking pretty okay. Okay, so I wonder if, I'm just going to hit the power button. So it's interesting, he should have a relatively full battery here. But, all right, he's already back to his grumpy self. And so presumably we will have some more fun, good features on there. I think I may do a separate video on that. But that is how you do the firmware upgrade on your iLEC, step by step. Hope this video helped. If it did, if you wouldn't mind, give me a thumbs up. Helps out the video a lot. And I hope to see you in the next video. I do lots of videos about iLECs, all sorts of smart home stuff, home robots, and all sorts of fun stuff like that. So hope to see you in the next one. Cheers. Oh, please give a like if you got some value from this. Thanks. Appreciate it.